Hey guys, my name is Coach Ray Rodriguez. Yes, I wear glasses. It's part of getting older. And I'm the head coach and the MMA instructor of Domain MMA. And I've had a lot of people asking me like, hey, could you put out a video on what it takes to be an MMA, you know, combatant, a fighter? So if you're based in Texas, this is what it normally takes. If you want to fight for a living as an amateur, as a pro, first of all, as an amateur, you can't make any money. Because once you take some form of payment, you become a pro, and that's going to put you in a different category. So let's say you want to walk into an MMA gym and you want to start fighting for the first time. So the first thing you're going to do is say, hey, I want to be a fighter. So the first thing a good coach is going to say is, hey, what's wrong with you? What issues do you have? Well, at that point, you can tell them, hey, I just want to fight because I love fighting. You know, nowadays you see everything on UFC. And so this gives you an opportunity to really delve into who you are as an individual. So you walk in the gym, first thing you have to do is you're going to train a lot. Now, most fighters, most MMA gyms require that you train 2 years. Why? Because we want you to be at least a blue belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. So if you go to the ground, you can take care of business efficiently. Then what else is required? Muay Thai, kickboxing, boxing, wrestling, judo, sambo, cage work. So obviously, you're going to train a lot. Now, at Domain MMA, I require that all the fighters have to train approximately 168 hours a month before I corner them. Now, why is that important? Because that's really significant. The more you train, the better you get. We have a philosophy at Domain MMA, a Vak Vituria Kudum, victory less preparation. And I don't like to lose. You know, I'm known for being the head coach to Joe Castaneda, who retired at 8-1. I'm also the head coach to Roy Sarabia, who's 14-2. Has 5 championship belts from 5 different promotions. He's ranked number 1 out of 2,000 fighters in the Southwest United States. The guy's an animal. He trains with me every day. And Roy's probably going to be fighting for Bellator or the UFC relatively soon. He's been training with me for 4 years, like I mentioned. And he fights for Combate America, and he gets paid to hurt people. And that's another thing. When you're a professional fighter, you get paid to hurt people. So why is that important? It's your mindset, your culture. You know, you step in the cage and you're making, you know, $10,000 for 9 minutes. You're going to want to, you know, hurt that person or at least prevent them from beating you. So here's the other thing, right? So you're going to have to train all the time. You're going to have to pretty much change your whole life to live at the gym. And the more you live at the gym, the better you're going to get. Now, here's the other thing too, right? You're going to learn all the skill sets that are necessary. So then what happens once you've been training? Now, a lot of times people ask me, you know, how long should I train? I normally recommend 1 to 2 years before I put you in the cage. Everybody's different. If you're an athlete, you can probably do it faster. But in my experience, and I've been an MMA coach now for 10 years, it takes about 2 years on average. So right as you're getting your blue belt, you're ready to fight. But that doesn't mean I can't throw you in sooner if you come in all the time and you train. When I first started training Roy Sarabia, I mean, within about a year and a half, the kid started fighting for us and he was terrorizing people. And I mean, terrorizing people. He actually went on record that he had 7 people back out of their fights, and they would come up to us the weigh-in and say, hey man, I don't want to fight your guy. And Roy and I would look at him like, wow, you waited to the weigh-in. So let's talk about that. So let's say you want to be a fighter. So now you're going to fill out some paperwork with the TDLR. You're going to pay $20 to them. That's going to register you for 1 year. And then more importantly, you're going to have to get your blood work done so you don't have any STD or HIV. You're going to get your eyes examined. You know, now you can fight even if you wear glasses and contacts, but you've got to have pretty good vision before you step in the cage. And then you're going to have a complete physical. Now, between the ages of 18 to 38, you're good to go. And your physical is good for 1 year. So that means in the state of Texas, you can fight all the time. Once you turn 38 in the state of Texas, you have to get an EKG and an EEG. And if that comes back negative, your fight career is over. The premise is the more concussions you get, the less likelihood you're going to continue to fight. And then, you know, we take you out to different venues. So we normally fight locally, then regionally, and then we try to go to other venues as well. So when I first got started 10 years ago, Premier Combat Group, PCG, was the premier fight organization here. And they went out of business, which happens. Right now, we try to fight for Fury Promotions, which is Eric Garcia, real good guy. And if we're not fighting here, we go to Dallas to fight for LFA, which is kind of like the feeder organization for the UFC. And if we're not fighting there, then we're going to go to Florida. We're going to go to Louisiana with Tim Credor, which runs BFC. And then if not, we'll go to FFC. There's a lot of promotions that invite us to fight all the time. I'm just very selective as a coach because if I've got to drive 14 hours to a venue, check in a hotel, and let my fighter fight, I've got to make sure he's going to win. But more importantly, he's going to get reimbursed. Here's the other thing, too. As an amateur, you pay your way. In the 10 years I've been a coach, I've never charged my fighters anything. I corner them. I do ask them for like $20 for supplies, hand wraps, tapes, and stuff like that. But, you know, recently I started asking them for gas money because we were traveling all the way to Louisiana, 12-hour trip. I was renting a van. And as a head coach, I'm paying for all that. It's coming out of my pocket. So, you know, it's something I love and I do. And another thing, right, for you guys that are looking for a good gym, first of all, walk into the gym, ask to see if the head coach or the MMA coach is belted in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Now, I'm not saying it's mandatory, but if the guy's not a BJJ black belt or a brown belt, you might want to reconsider training at that gym. Also, what other accomplishments has he had? Is he a kickboxer? Is he a boxer? Is he a wrestler? If he can't answer that, you know, it's not mandatory. You know, Greg Jackson didn't really fight, but he knew how to develop a program with John Winklejohn. The guy's created a lot of champions. So it's not necessary, but it is important. And then ask the coach, you know, does he know how to wrap hands? And I'm not talking like, you know, basic wrap. I'm talking like a boxer's wrap, professional wrap. And is he a cut man? If your coach has those qualifications, then you should also ask him for his tombstone. How many fighters is he trained? What's his MMA record? The beautiful thing about MMA, you cannot BS in MMA. If you go to Tapology.com and you type in the fighter's name, it will tell you their entire record from amateur to pro. And so when a guy comes in and says, hey, man, I'm 32-0 as a fighter, you go, cool, what's your first last name? Go to Tapology. You'll find out everything you need to know about that fighter right there and then. Now, in 10 years, you'll have a lot of people. I've had a lot of people say, well, you know, I fought for blood. Okay, question mark. There are smokers. Smokers are like when you go to a gym and you say, hey, I want to fight. But those aren't actually documented. So if the guy says he's got, you know, 55 smokers, that doesn't mean he's a great fighter. You know, he could fight 55 people, but that doesn't mean he's won any belts and stuff like that. And then more importantly, right, in my experience, if, you know, if a coach has been a real good athlete and a world champion, it doesn't mean he's going to be a great coach. So you got to find a coach that loves you. Now, what I mean by that is that he's going to put everything into you. You know, I train Royce Saraiva 2 to 3 times a day, 7 days a week, especially during fight camps. And it's a lot of work above and beyond. You know, right now it's 10:35. We trained today and I'm still here. And I figured I'd make this video because I get a lot of people always asking me like, hey, Coach Ray, I want to be a fighter. You know, what are the requirements? So like I said, it's pretty simple. You're going to train for 2 years at a minimum. But if you're an athlete, it should be faster. You're going to have to get your blood exams, your full body exam, your eye exam. And then you're going to have to register with the Texas Department of License and Registration. It's $20. And then your license is good for a year. It says you're actually an MMA fighter. And then you're going to fight. And you're going to fight all the time. And I can't emphasize, as an amateur, you can't take any money. As a pro, you can get paid. Now, let me be very honest with you for you guys that want to be pro fighters. I've met a lot of athletes that said, hey, I went to this gym and they signed me up as a pro MMA fighter from day one. I don't believe that. I think the reality is you should have at least 7 to 10 amateur fights, maybe have 2 or 3 belts and then turn pro. But that's me. I've actually met some coaches that said, hey, man, the dude came in. He looked like an athlete. I signed him up to be a pro. And now he's 0-8 as a pro. Your record is going to determine your value. So if you suck as a fighter, you're not going to get paid the big bucks. So let me explain that. Some promoters will pay you $500 to show. That means you make weight, you go to the weigh-ins and you show up. And then they'll pay you $500 to win. So you made $1,000 for 9 minutes. It's not a lot of money. Depending on how your record rises up, some guys are making $5,000 to show, $5,000 to win. So for basically a 9-minute fight, you're making $10,000. Now, here's the other thing you need to remember is every time you fight, and you go past one round, you have a 1 week suspension. So if you fight, you know, three rounds, there's a 3 week suspension. So if you're going to fight in, for example, November 1st, and you're going to, and you go three rounds, you can't fight until December. So that's something important. The state mandates that for your health and well-being. So obviously, you know, I do this for a living. I'm one of the most successful MMA coaches in San Antonio. I own and operate Domain MMA. I'm also a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt, and I have other black belts as well. So if you guys have any questions or concerns, you want to know more about MMA, I will help you in a way I can, because I think an informed athlete is someone that can be more successful. So guys, thanks so much for this live stream. This is my first live stream. I was kind of nervous. You actually see me wearing my glasses. So hope you guys are doing well. Y'all take care and have a great day. Bye. Hey, what's up?